In this video, I'm going to talk about five everyday habits that make your heart sick and give you some practical tips on what you can do to reverse that. Unfortunately, your first heart attack may be your last. Every year, over 800,000 people get heart attacks in the United States. That means someone has a heart attack every 40 seconds. And we've seen far too many young people die of sudden death. So don't let this be you. Number one is abusing caffeine. Small amounts of caffeine for most people are not dangerous. However, people who are using caffeine as a stimulant easily build up tolerance, and before they know it, they are dependent upon it to be alert and to work.
Coffee. One cup is often enough. I usually have six.
And the problem is caffeine comes with side effects because you have caffeine receptors all over your body. It stimulates your heart rate, it elevates your blood pressure, it prevents you from relaxing, and it dehydrates you. It can reduce your blood flow and increase stress hormones such as cortisol, which elevates your blood pressure as well as your blood sugar. Both become this inflammatory process that's bad for your health. No one consumes caffeine by itself. It's bitter, so people usually buy it in an energy drink or blend it in a coffee with a ton of sugar, with other chemicals like creamers and artificial flavors. Think about your body like a expensive luxury car. Are you going to put just any gas to power it? You will ruin your gas tank as well as your engine. And when you consume chemicalized food and beverages, you're going to ruin your gut as well as your immunity and your metabolism. Energy drinks have been proven to raise your blood pressure at about an hour and a half after you drink it. And my plumber actually had a renal artery dissection because he was abusing energy drinks. So please wean off caffeine. You know you are addicted when you get headaches and feel bad when you don't have it. One great way to wean off is to drink green tea. Caffeine in green tea is about the third of the amount of caffeine in coffee, and it's also packaged with more anti-inflammatory and antiviral phytonutrients. Number two, if you have high blood pressure, two or more caffeine may double your risk of heart death. But you don't wake up with high blood pressure overnight unless you are having a stroke or heart attack. Usually it's a lifelong process from eating high sodium, excessive calories, excessive fats, especially processed foods. And whether it's protein, carbs, or fats, anything excessive is bad for you. So if you're not checking your blood pressure daily, you should. You need to know these numbers. 70% of Americans have either high blood pressure or are pre-hypertensive. And one visit to the doctor's office annually doesn't mean your blood pressure is good for the rest of the year. If you're taking a pill, don't count on it to work, right? 75% of people taking a blood pressure pill still don't have normal blood pressure. And that's because pills don't address the root cause, which is your diet, as well as your weight and your lack of exercise. The importance is literally in that order, right? You can't outrun or out-exercise a bad diet. So you should always check with your doctor before you start exercising. You don't want to end up with sudden death from collapsing because of the stressor of exercise. Number three is skipping greens and beans. I don't know what you eat, but I bet you don't eat enough greens and beans because 90% of Americans have the same problem. Dark leafy greens and beans have critical nutrients such as potassium, magnesium, as well as phytonutrients that help to lower your inflammation and your blood pressure. And these ingredients are protective for your heart, for your immunity, for your metabolism. And they're missing in processed foods. They're missing in meat as well as in dairy products. Beans and leafy greens protect you from the insulin spikes, the excessive calories. It reduces type 2 diabetes complications. It reduces bad cholesterol as well as inflammation. So please eat them first. And this will help you avoid saturated fat and oils and processed sugar. By eating some greens first, you'll fill your tummy up and you won't need as much of those foods. Now, if you're bloated and pass a lot of gas after eating beans, just know that that's normal, but it's uncomfortable. That means you're feeding your gut microbiome, which needs a lot of TLC to help you change your metabolism. So do this slowly by increasing your tolerance. Start with just like what, a teaspoon of beans, and then add a little bit every day with every meal. And then pretty soon you'll be to 1 to 3 cups of bean a day. Not counting dietary fiber is a huge mistake. Fiber is super important for your heart health. Number one, it reduces cholesterol. Number two, it actually decreases inflammation to reduce your blood pressure to promote blood flow. When you eat whole food fiber, it comes with phytonutrients that actually help promote blood flow. And this is why if you're not reaching your fiber minimum intake, which I would say is is 40 grams daily, then you're missing out on these health benefits for your heart. Now you want to make sure that you're not doing this in like dehydrated fiber, right? You got to eat real food. When you eat real food, it comes with the phytonutrients that aren't in this package. It's really eating a diversity of foods that keeps you healthy. You can start by adding leafy greens as well as beans. Just know that you can't go from, you know, very minimum fiber to, let's say, 10, 12 grams of fiber to 40 grams. You won't feel well. You won't feel well for two reasons. Number one, you're actually feeding your gut microbiome, and so it's making gas and to make you fart, right? And number two, fiber draws in water. That's why they have to take out fiber in processed foods, because it draws in water. It actually makes food go bad faster, right? Keeps it moist, makes it mold, as well as it won't give you that cake-like texture that you like in your breads and your cakes because it's wet. So the goal is, you know, start slow, eat like a teaspoon a day of a bean. And if you can tolerate that, can add another one, add one for every meal. And pretty soon you got a cup a day if you spread it out. And then ultimately, you know, it would be nice if you can eat 3 cups a day. Now, fiber helps you to use a bathroom regularly, because if you don't, you're actually not completely evacuated the toxins that have accumulated in your body. Toxins such as hormones like estrogen, as well as the heavy metals that are in your food or pesticides that are in your food. I had mentioned earlier, by eating fiber, you're actually reducing cholesterol, right? And all these things help your heart. It really helps everything, every organ in your body. You know, even if you're having bowel movements, if you don't feel like you're completely empty, that's actually constipation. People who poop pellets, are not pooping every day, are constipated. And it's important that you make sure your bowel movements are regular. And one way to ensure that is to eat more fiber. You may be told by your gastroenterologist, you know, if they find polyps, to go get like some supplement. No, eat real food, right? Yeah, you could do the supplement, but when you take the supplement, you're actually filling up your stomach, so you have less room for eating real food. And real food comes not only with fiber, but it comes with nutrients like protein, carbohydrates, and fats, as well as phytonutrients that aren't found in that fiber supplement. Some people take laxatives to help them poop. I would caution you about that. A lot of laxatives actually irritate your gut lining. They actually can promote more inflammation. So I understand, you know, some people need that for help. And I would say you probably have not found the right food to help you go. Prunes are very good. Prune juice is very good. Chia seeds, when you rehydrate them and get them to have that glossy coat, is also very good to promoting good bowel movements. And it's not just laxatives that irritate your gut. Medications oftentimes irritate your gut and can alter your gut microbiome as well. So people who are on birth control pills, antidepressants, antibiotics, proton pump inhibitors, diabetic or cardiac medications. I mean, really, I can't think of a medication that doesn't interfere with your gut health and ultimately change your biochemistry and affect every single organ, including your heart. Remember, everything in life that we do will affect your heart, because it is the organ that always has to be on. So our foods can either stress our heart or it can help our heart. When we exercise, is actually a stress for our heart, and this is why we need to get the food right. And when we sleep, that actually helps our heart if we're getting good sleep. So our food and our lifestyle shouldn't really be interfering in our sleep. And when it does, you know your food may not be the right food for you. So best to you in your healthcare journey. I hope this video was helpful. And if you like this video, please join me on my next one.